the University of Wyoming Extension, and today we're going to talk about fix and freeze cooking. Fix and freeze cooking is preparing numerous meals, whatever you're comfortable with. I recommend for starting out possibly 4 to 6 meals. You prep them and then you put them in the freezer. That way you can pull them out and use them later. I've used this method a ton over the years. So why do I cook this way? 1, it saves time. 2, it saves me money. I'm not going to the store and impulse buying. And 3, it's a healthier way for me to eat because I control what I put in my recipes. So for the first step, I have developed a list for you. So you don't need to take notes. It'll be on the website and available for you to print. First thing you need to do is choose your recipes. Now I recommend you choose recipes that are already prepared for fix and freeze. And then you can gradually move into your own recipes once you get the steps and the process down. You can go to your local library for books. You can also get on the internet and see if you can find some recipes. Once I choose my recipes, I make a list of ingredients. And then once I create that shopping list, I go to the store. Now I do recommend you shop and prep one day and cook the next day. Doing it all in one day is just too much. So I break it up into 2 steps and 2 days. They can be Saturday and Sunday, for example. Maybe you go Friday night and then cook on Sunday. It really doesn't matter. Whatever works for you and your schedule. Once I get ready, I have to clean out my freezer. You've got to have lots of room in your freezer. You need to prep your kitchen. So get out all your ingredients, get out your pots and pans and utensils, and be ready. It just makes the process go so much faster. Now remember, you've got to have food safety basics. Wash your hands before you start. Make sure your countertops are clean. Have a rag ready for any spills and messes that you might need to clean up. Once you get everything prepped and in the freezer, then you have meals to come. But once you get it prepped and put in the freezer, you'll have to thaw it to cook. Now you can thaw in 1 of 4 ways. My favorite is in the fridge overnight. So I'll take my freezer meal out the day or two before I plan to use it and let it thaw in the fridge. You can also use a microwave if you have baggies or containers that are microwave safe. But you have to remember to cook it immediately after you thaw it in the microwave. The next way is to thaw as part of the cooking process. So for example, I might have a casserole in a tin pan that I've prepared. So I'll just pull it from the freezer, put it in the oven, and cook it from the frozen state. Now it does take longer, but you have a delicious hot meal at the end of the time. And then again, you can take your meal that was in the freezer and thaw it under cool running water. Once I get it thawed enough, if say it's in a baggie, then I can cut my baggie off and then continue to cook it as necessary, whether it's in this oven, on the stovetop, or in a slow cooker. So today we are going to make a meatball soup with garden veggies. Now you can use any veggies you want. You can also use a variety of meats. But let's see how this process works. As you can see, I've gathered all my ingredients and I've prepped everything. So for this recipe, I need zucchini. So I'm going to put the zucchini in a small baggie. Now the reason I do that is because zucchini does not take very long to cook. And I want to add it towards the very end of the cooking process. So I'm going to put it in its own separate bag. The next step for the meatball and garden veggie recipe is to use a big baggie. Now these are freezer baggies, so they're thick. I like to roll down the edge of the baggie. I'm going to open it up and I place it into a bowl. Now, the reason I do that is because I have liquids in this recipe, and I don't want my baggie to lean over and spill. So I've learned that it's best to put it in a bowl, and if I spill, I've rolled this over so I don't get anything into the zipper part so that it doesn't freeze properly. Just little tips to make it easier. So the first thing I'm going to do for this recipe is I'm going to use meatballs that are already cooked. I poured them into my baggie. Now again, you can use other meats. If you cook this for a long time, you could use diced chicken. If you want it to cook relatively quickly, then use a pre-cooked meat, such as meatballs, maybe a smoked sausage, whatever your family likes. The great thing about a soup is you can make it any way you like it. For this recipe, I'm going to use carrots, and I've already diced and chopped them up. Now, when you do this, you can make the carrots bigger. I've made them pretty fine because if I'm in a hurry, I want the carrots to cook relatively quickly. I have tomatoes. When you have that overabundance of tomatoes in the fall, this makes a great way to use them up. After that, I'm going to put in 2 cans of white beans. These are cannellinis, but use your favorite variety. The beans are rinsed and drained. As you can see, my bag is getting pretty full. I'm going to add some dehydrated onions. I'm going to use about 1 heaping tablespoon. You can use more if you would like. You can also use fresh onion, but I happen to have a lot of dehydrated onions available just for this purpose. And because this is a soup and there's a lot of liquid, they rehydrate. Next, I'm going to add 24 ounces of your favorite pasta sauce. This happens to be roasted garlic. I'm going to try to get the air out of the bag and seal it up. Now, if you would like, you can mix this up just a little bit and make a nice mixture. Now, there's one more thing that the recipe has in it, and it calls for 4 cups of chicken broth. Now, I do not add my chicken broth until I cook my soup, because adding 4 more cups to this bag just makes it really hard to freeze, and it's just much easier to add this once this other mixture is thawed. I'm going to tape my zucchini bag onto this because, again, I've decided I want to add the zucchini at the last minute. Now that I have them all mixed together, I'm going to lay it flat and I'll put it in the freezer. Now the thing to remember is you don't want to stack too many things that are not frozen together. So that's why you cleaned out your freezer so you have a lot of room. Again, another thing I do is I label what's in my package. I put that it serves 6. I put the date that I prepared this. I put the instructions right here. Because when I pull it out, I don't want to have to go dig and find the recipe that I used. So on here it says thaw overnight in the refrigerator. Add contents to a slow cooker. Cook on low for 6 to 8 hours. But it also has that I need to add 4 cups of chicken broth once I put it in the slow cooker. And of course I add the zucchini the last 30 minutes of cooking. Again, this is super easy. It took me just minutes. And once you get used to doing this, you'll find that it really does save you time in the long run and money, and it's a healthier way to eat. You can find, again, the the instructions for freezer cooking and the recipe for this meatball and garden veggie soup on the website. I hope you enjoy freezer cooking in the future.